you are here and you're investing in this community, you're investing in our children. I am here today to just say thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for shopping at Farmers Market, Carroll Park. Thank you for supporting new businesses on Washington Boulevard. Thank you for putting the seat, the trees in Pigtown. Thank you for planting alleys and planting gardens in College Market. Thank you for being a true example of what community is all about. It's these progressive actions that go a long way in reducing blight and reducing crime. We want the bad guys to be uncomfortable and think twice, right, before they come into our communities and commit crimes. So let me just tell you, I can't do this by myself. We have, let me just say, the mainstream media, they're not going to focus on this. They want to focus on the negativity because that's what sells. We have prosecuted 50,000 cases a year in Baltimore City. Last year, we had a 93% felony conviction rate. We convicted every single public enemy number one that was designated by the Baltimore Police Department. Let me tell you, of those 12 individuals, there's only four more pending. They're facing 8 life sentences plus 600 years.
Right.
So we're going to go hard on the individuals that deserve to go hard and be tough on them, right? But for far too long, we haven't looked for long-term sustainable solutions. We haven't made an investment in our young people, and we haven't addressed the systemic issues as to why crimes take place. So I'm here tonight to say to you, the way that we were able to secure those convictions wasn't because we had the Baltimore Police Department that risked their lives each and every day for us. It wasn't because I have the most talented prosecutors in the country, which I do. It was the seizing woman from the community that lived there for 40 years. The one that, when the BGF executioner lured somebody onto a playground in broad daylight and shot him twice in the head in front of his pregnant girlfriend. It was the seizing woman that said, oh, no, 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 that's my name. That's how he was able to receive life plus 50 years. We all understand, we recognize that at the end of the day, there are more of us than the negative, the small number of individuals that define that negative perception of our city. So we cannot do this without each and every one of you. Our goals together are so much attainable when we work together. We have to lift each other up, empower one another, and overcome the challenges that we all face. And we must do it together because we're stronger together. So again, I'm here to thank each and every one of you. And I want to say from the bottom of my heart, as the top prosecutor in this city, thank you, Southwest Partnership.
So we had 5 nominations last year. I know we normally have 3 recipients, but because these 5 individuals just stood out across the board, we actually wanted to go ahead and present all 5 from there now. We're going to nominate all about 5 candidates. Our first candidate is Ben Hyman, the executive director of Pigtown Main Street. He was awarded for leadership in bringing Washington Boulevard back to life. Our second recipient is Ms. Sonia Eby. She's the president of Pigtown. She was awarded for leadership back to the community association. recipient is Ms. Aparna Jain. She was former president of Citizens of Pigtown. She was nominated for the Community for Change. All right. Come on down, Ms. Aparna. She's in the back. She's coming around. While you take the picture, I'm just going to read the names of the recipients. Come on down, and we can just have you there. Our third recipient is Ben Browning, president of the Ministry. He's the ultimate cheerleader for all 7 years of democracy. And also, his big brother, he was a former architect from that period. Did he leave back home? And he did go change his clothes. He said he was coming back. We're going to hold this one up here for him. We have Mr. Stephen Fleck. He's the pastor of New Southwest Baptist Church in our Union Square area. He's a leader in guiding the big communities to be engaged at the street level of the community building. And now I know he wasn't able to be here, but his wife is. Ms. Fleck, would you mind coming to receive the award of his honor? He didn't tell us he wasn't going to be here prior to. So excuse me, I said 5, it was only 4. So again, please give a round of applause to all of our community members and board of directors. It's amazing to be organized by this community level. I want to thank you for this presentation. I want to host you. All right. Next, we're going to have our committee presidents come up. They're going to kind of speak a bit about what the committee goals for 2018 is. I know a lot of you are students and learn what the Southwest Partnership has in store. Many of you have probably received a huge letter already in the mail. So they know you see about some money that's developed in the communities as we build together. First up, I would like to welcome our Historic Preservation Committee President, Scott Cashman.
Celebrate that in order to